The city weeps as, for the first time ever, a hockey arena becomes a scene of violence, following a concert by Spinal Tap.
I hope my poor little baby's okay.
See for yourself.
Of course, it would be wrong to suggest that this sort of mayhem began with rock and roll. After all, there were riots at the premiere of Mozart's The Magic Flute. So, what's the answer? Ban all music? In this reporter's opinion, the answer, sadly, is yes.
This is Kent Brockman with a special live report from the headquarters of crusty opponent John Armstrong. How can I prove we're live? Penis!
Crisis at Camp Krusty.
Ladies and gentlemen, I've been to Vietnam, Afghanistan, and Iraq, and I can say without hyperbole that this is a million times worse than all of them put together. A group of school-age Spartacuses has taken this camp by force. Three counselors are missing and presumed scared. What's that? I'm being told I can have an exclusive interview with the ringleader.
Don't be the boy. Don't be the boy.
No!
Tragic news tonight. 120 dead in a tidal wave in Kuala Lumpur. Kuala Lumpur. France.
Yoink.
Yoink.
We're just about to get our first pictures from inside the spacecraft with average not Homer Simpson. And we'd like to... Ladies and gentlemen, we've just lost the picture, but what we've seen speaks for itself. The Corvair spacecraft has apparently been taken over, conquered, if you will, by a master race of giant space ants. It's difficult to tell from this vantage point whether they will consume the captive Earthman or merely enslave them. One thing is for certain, there is no stopping them. The ants will soon be here. And I, for one, welcome our new insect overlords. I'd like to remind them that as a trusted TV personality, I can be helpful in rounding up others to toil in their underground sugar caves.
Don't worry, kids. I'm sure your father's all right.
What are you basing that on, Mom?
Who wants ginger snaps?
Well, this reporter was possibly a little hasty earlier. We'd like to reaffirm his allegiance to this country and its human president. May not be perfect, but it's still the best government we have. For now. Oh, yes. By the way, the spacecraft's still in extreme danger. May not make it back. Attempting risky reentry. Blah, 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 blah. We'll see you after the movie. This is hour 57 of our live round-the-clock coverage outside the Simpson estate. Remember, by the way, to tune in tonight at 8 o'clock for highlights of today's vigil, including when the garbage man came and when Marge Simpson put the cat out. Possibly because it was harassed, we don't know. Of course, there's no way to see into the Simpson home without some kind of infrared heat-sensitive camera. So let's turn it on. Now, this technology is new to me, but I'm pretty sure that's Homer Simpson in the oven, rotating slowly. His body temperature has risen to over 400 degrees. He's literally stewing in his own juices. Dozens of people are gunned down each day in Springfield, but until now, none of them was important. I'm Kent Brockman. At 3 p.m. Friday, local autocrat C. Montgomery Burns was shot following a tense confrontation at Town Hall. Burns was rushed to a nearby hospital where he was pronounced dead. He was then transferred to a better hospital where doctors upgraded his condition to alive. Now let's talk to Police Chief Wiggum.
Oh, hiya, Kent. Right now, we are questioning two witnesses who were in the vicinity at the time.
Seem to be evacuating the town for some unknown reason. Professor, without knowing precisely what the danger is, would you say it's time for our viewers to crack each other's heads open and feast on the goo inside?
Yes, I would, Ken.
This kind of language has no place on or off TV. And that's my two cents. That ought to hold those SOBs. What the...